Hi, once again, welcome to Shortcut Guide. I'm once again delighted to present to you a new tutorial about Holyrics. Now, in today's video, I've decided just to share with you the new version of Holyrics in 2024, about Holyrics, 2024. Now, Holyrics was established in 2016, as you can see. It has gone on developing with adding in new features in its application until this year, 2024. Now, I want to just show you how new features and also show you how to add in an image using Holyrics. If you want to learn how to display the Bible using Holyrics, you can go direct to my channel and just click on that video and you watch it. If you want to learn how to create new themes using Holyrics, there's also an opportunity to learn how to create them using Holyrics on my channel. You can just go there and watch, and don't also forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Now, it's adding an image in Holyrics is so simple. You just come here and this is where the images are displayed. Now, these are the images which have been displaying for some particular period of time. But how to add an image, you just come here to file explorer, your file explorer obviously, and then you come to pictures, click on the image which you had to add. Let me say that I want to add this one here, and I said that let me copy. You copy it, copy, or you can select it and then you say Control C on your computer. That is a shortcut on Windows 10. And then you come here to your computer and you say that paste. After pasting, the image will appear just right here. Now, if I want to display it, I just say that Control F6, or you just say, you right click and then you say show. It will show on the screens. And if you want to first view it before you display it on a computer, you come here to view, and then you view it on your computer before you display it on a projector. Simple as that. And after, if you want to move away from that viewpoint, you just click aside of the image like here, and then you go over the image. As simple as that. So that's how you can add an image using Holyrics. Another features I want to show you, how to edit. I showed you last time a video how to edit your new songs in Holyrics and everything. If you have missed out that video, you can just go to my channel and just click and watch that video. But here they have added a new feature. You come here to new, yeah, obviously. Let me just go back. Not seeing the changes. You come here to new and select new song, or Control 1 takes you to a new platform like this. Here's where you write the title of the song. Let me say that forever, simple as that. First of all, we have a spelling checker on Holyrics. If you have written a letter, a word which is not there in English, it will show like that. But if you have reset it with a small letter, it will also show like that. So this enables you to also correct your errors and mistakes in grammar and everything. So this is a new feature which has been added in Holyrics. You come here, and this is a spell checker. You accept it, check all the words, allow anyone to start with a capital letter. These are the things. Check the word and lowercase, which here after break. All these ones here, you enable them and you say that okay. And after that, so after writing the name forever, spell checking and everything, here you write the text of the name. Let me say that just me, or mo, let me say that me, and the notes, everything, author, copyright and everything. So there's another option which has been added. It is called extra. Now here you are allowed to customize your writing of the songs and everything. You can add here platform which you want. Let me say that I want to add the country where the person comes from, country where the author of the song comes from, and you click OK. They'll bring another option here. Let me say that Uganda, obviously I come from Uganda. That is the author of the song. That's where the author of that song comes from. You can add as many as you want. That is one of the things. And here you can also show where you have watched, you downloaded it from, either from TikTok or Spotify, or can be YouTube or any other channel. And you are also allowed to search for whatever thing you want to search, and the key in which he was singing the song, you know, and everything. so that you can easily and the time, all the choruses and everything, you can write them there. You can add here an extra information to the person who's going to display the song, what it is all about and everything like that. And afterwards, you can just close this and you start retyping the name forever, which you can write all of that. You remember that you're having a spelling checker. You can ignore all or add to the dictionary the word, everything. So this is another feature which has been added. Obviously, when you want to change the word, the theme of the song you have been writing, here are the different themes. And if you have not yet watched that video about how to create themes in Holyrics, it is already posted on my channel. You can just go direct and watch it, because it is a great video. I posted 1 year ago and it shows how to create themes in Holyrics, how to customize and everything. So this is another these are different themes you can add. Another feature which is in Holyrics here, you can give different themes. Watch it again. You can give different themes on different slides. You can give a different Holyrics has been adding on other videos how to display using your phone. You can use display using your phone. I have a video about that. You can just go to my channel and watch it if you want to learn how to display using your phone in Holyrics and everything. So another new thing which has been added in Holyrics, when you come to Bible, obviously there is this theme here. In my current video about how to display a Bible, I did not so much interfere into this. So today I've just decided to show you how to use this feature here. It is custom or automatic representation. You come here, so you look for the verses which you want. For example, let me say that I want John 3:16. I'm just scrolling down. John 3:16. I choose verse 16 and I come here, I can select it, and then I say that add to the what you'll be adding here to the playlist. Now I have some verses which I already added, but you can also remove some of the apps just selecting it, some of the what the Bible verses, and then select them. You can bring them back to this side, and this allows me to do what, to display. You can display automatically. For example, when the preacher has finished to preach and you want to display something on your computer, just display automatically here, and you can give it also time. You said, let me select some time here. Let me reduce on the time. Let me say that 3 seconds, because I just want to show you as an illustration. And I said that repeat also. And so I've said automatically, and then I click show. Now these verses are going to show. Every verse is going to show like 3 seconds, 3 seconds, 3 seconds, 3 seconds, and it will turn over and it will repeat. And if you want to move from that side, you obviously have to press escape and you move from that side. And another thing about this is that you can highlight the verses. For example, you click here and highlight. If the preacher is stressing something, for example, whoever refreshes others, it will be what? Refresh. I just select this and I say that highlight. You can highlight by aligning it, and you close after closing, and then you display show. Your word will be underlined. For example, when the preacher is doing what? Displaying is emphasizing that. Or you can also, it allows you to also do what? To highlight. You can remove the highlight here, and when I display it, it will not be having an underline. Or and I click, let me click escape. And another thing is that you can highlight again. It allows you to bolden the words, italicize the words. For example, when you select them and you italicize, bold and italicize the words, this is how it is going to appear. Let me just leave that one out and show you another way. Is that when you select that word, you can choose the color which you want it to be displayed in. Let me say that I have chosen this color. I want it to appear like that on the projector, in this color, the projector I choose, and it will appear like this. And I come here and I say show. When I show it, you can see that the color is like that. So that was it for today. If you don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this, because I'm posting a video every while and then. And also share this video to with different people, your friends, your relatives and every person who is using Holyrics to display. This is a convenient software for us to use. Thank you for watching. I love you so much. Goodbye.